And now it's time to introduce our first keynote speaker. We have four keynote speakers today to address you, to share the wisdom of them with you. And I'm very proud to invite on the stage Mr. Dumitru Dorin Prunariu, the first and the single Romanian who went to space and saw our beautiful Earth from the space, and I think it's very connected with what we are doing here. So,
good morning. I didn't know exactly from the very beginning about the dress code with all these t-shirts. I will wear gladly one. But unfortunately, I come with my tie to be very serious and to deliver you a very important speech. I hope you'll appreciate it. Okay, the space programs have become a major force to be applied in meeting this century's challenges. For most of spacefaring nations, these challenges are referring to providing clean and affordable energy, preventing environmental degradation, meeting new needs for education, sustaining global economic competitiveness, improving technologies for transportation and medical care, promoting beneficial international relations, and of course, ensuring national security. In this century, from which two decades have already passed, civil space activities affect our daily lives and also advance the national interest of many nations in a variety of ways. Space systems today play integral roles in government business and personal communications, positioning and navigation, in weather monitoring and forecasting, in producing remote sensing information for agriculture, urban land use planning and natural resources management, in commercial enterprises that are becoming increasingly significant factors in global economic competitiveness, and in opening new windows on humanity's place in the universe. Because civil space endeavors are technologically and intellectually challenging, they stimulate innovation that over the long term leads to advance with applications beyond the space sector. Recognizing the importance of research and technological innovation, it is recommended strengthening science and engineering research to enhance the quality of life, to promote new ideas in the economy, and to provide security. Investments in research in and from space can lead to important future societal benefits. The beginning of the third millennium is characterized by the emergence of the information society. In this society, information has become an important resource as a particular type of goods in terms of commercial, private, and public interests. Space offers a multitude of critical opportunities unavailable in Earth-based laboratories to extend our knowledge of the local and distant universe and to search for life beyond Earth. As you know, in May 1981, I accomplished a space flight during which I surrounded the Earth 125 times, traveling 5,260,000 kilometers with a speed of 28,000 kilometers per hour in 7 days, 20 hours, and 42 minutes. During the flight, I conducted 22 scientific experiments that aimed to obtain valuable information for extending knowledge in the field of astrophysics, nuclear physics, space technology, biomedicine. Because I'm a cosmonaut, I want to mention here the fact that human spaceflight continues to challenge technology, utilize unique human capabilities, bring global prestige, and excite the public's imagination. Space provides almost limitless opportunities for extending the human experience to new frontiers. Cosmonauts and astronauts are specialized in complex fields of activity, appreciated in specialized organizations and beyond. With the same respect and appreciation anywhere in the world, people spoke about Yuri Gagarin and John Glenn, or about Alexei Leonov and Neil Armstrong, as well as about many other space flyers representing the 37 states that have so far participated in the manned space flights. Today, the International Space Station represents the most complex and expensive international collaboration project, being permanently inhabited by numerous international crews. Because of the growing strategic importance of space, all nations that aspire to global or regional political and economic leadership in this century are developing and increasing their spacefaring capabilities. The increase of the information and communication tools and of the information availability in the past decade has led to an increase in data stream and data volume has enlarged in geometric progression each year. To process this data became a real challenge for specialized institutions. I have the opportunity to make a comprehensive assessment of how cosmic information was obtained and processed almost 40 years ago during my space flight and how this is happening today. To not think that there were onboard computers in the sense of those existing today, that the information was stored in storage media as today, or that the processing of information on board was done computerized. My spaceship could realize 16 automatic programs that provided operations of orientation and control of different systems, this being realized with electromechanical systems. Regarding experiments, they were made with miniaturized devices which had electronic equipment included, but not for storing information. This being done either on the ground by transmitting data through the telemetry system or by manually recording it by the cosmonauts and analyzing and its subsequent processing to the ground. I recorded images of the Earth, took multispectral photos, but all on film. These were later brought to the ground, developed, and information used. The concept of digital information processing was the introductory phase to the next generation of spaceships compared to the one on which I flew. Today, it is unimaginable not to have digital equipment on board any vehicle. We're talking now about gigabytes of information conveyed daily, individually, in the private environment, not to mention the professional one. On board the International Space Station, one records, processes, transmits, and receives terabytes of information daily. Today, satellites transmit real-time, daily, terabytes of information from outer space. The volume of data has reached such a high level that its processing is almost impossible by digital means still considered normal. Since 2004, the emergence of the technological platforms which provide real-time, large-scale data processing and include deeper analytical tools has increased the value of data once more. Because of that, the joint analysis of structured and unstructured data and acquisition of new knowledge and useful data out of them is very important for making new scientific discoveries, fast and accurate responding to the incidents at the public and private organizations, making reasonable decisions, as well as for national security and public health areas. In this regard, big data technologies are attracting the attention of the scientific, industrial, business, and other areas, including the public sector, the largest producer and consumer of data. Big data analytics, it's increasingly widespread in multiple industries, from using machine learning in banking and financial services to healthcare and government, and open source big data tools are the mainframe of any big data architect's toolkit. I have a long collaboration with the UN Committee on the Peaceful Uses of Outer Space, representing Romania at its sessions since 1992, being chairman of the Scientific and Technical Subcommittee of this UN Committee for the period 2004-2006, and chairman of the full committee for the period 2010-2012, now I have the privilege to be the vice chairman of the Working Group on Space 2030 Agenda. One of the permanent demands by developing countries at the level of this UN committee is the free access to space data obtained by spacefaring nations. One of the main challenges is that the space sector and those who use spatial data do not really communicate with each other. Thus, there is lack of understanding of end users' needs and capabilities. Capacity building and training are essential to that first responders can really benefit from what space has to offer. Fancy data will not make a difference if no one knows how to use it. Another challenge is a lack of coordination among the space community itself. There are a lot of useful information, initiatives, and programs, but they appear to be working alone instead of working together towards a common goal, such as assisting in crisis management. Each space entity works with different standards, formats, rules, requirements, and specifications, making coordination very difficult. It is not difficult to obtain some sort of data. The challenge is to obtain the right data that could be useful to the end user. There will always be challenges and issues. In space activities, the efforts made are in most cases conjugated and the results are mostly shared at global level. The role of international organizations and other entities in the space field is of a great importance in promoting space activities at national, regional, inter-regional, and global levels. I would like to underline the particular role of regional mechanisms in providing platforms for enhancing coordination and cooperation between spacefaring nations and emerging space nations and in establishing partnerships between users and providers of space-based services. When some of the above-mentioned challenges are slowly overcome, space will be able to play a bigger role. The important thing to remember is that space is becoming a very important tool all over the world. The technology is improving each year, and more high-quality data is becoming available. The challenges are not on the technological level, but on the political, institutional level. Once we all learn how to play well together and share, space technology will be even more beneficial for humanity. There was a strong momentum for the heads of states of the G8 nations, G7 if you want now, with Russia, the European Union, international organizations, throughout the national laws and policies for full, free, and open access to public sector digital data so that the benefits of public investment in such data can be maximized with as few barriers to use as possible. While open data for society at large is a relatively new phenomenon, the space sector has been accustomed to open data for all of its existence, especially in astronomy and navigation, but also in Earth observation. Mentioning here the strong influence of Copernicus and other successful space programs. Free and open source software for Geospatial, the flagship event of open source software Geospatial Foundation, is the biggest global open source for Geospatial conference in the year, with a traditional offer of over a decade. Earth observation community, driven by important policy drivers like UN 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development, the Paris Climate Agenda, and the Sendai Framework for Disaster Risk Reduction, is transforming today the concepts like big data, open data, digital economy, high-performance computing, cloud-based technology, exploitation platforms in the common language in the geospatial world in which the Phosphor-G community can significantly contribute to make them reality. I wish this important conference in Bucharest a successful work, and congratulations to the organizers. Thank you very much.